I will discuss the overcurrent problem of the mini split air conditioner inverter circuit board, what things could go bad, and what components we need to check when an overcurrent problem is shown on the circuit board. This circuit board is a Fujitsu 1.5 ton unit. Let me show you what problem has occurred in this circuit board and how I will fix it. All the resistors over here in this circuit board have been blown up. Some of them are also short-circuited. This is the filtration circuit over here in the circuit board. First is the line filter. These smaller and these three bigger capacitors. The electricity directly passes towards this rectification circuit from these capacitors. After rectification, these resistors are mounted here. These are shunt resistors. These resistors are used for overcurrent protection in this circuit board. Due to the overcurrent passed in this circuit, they have gotten into this condition. After this circuit, the PFC circuit is mounted further, and the reactor is installed, which is used to make the power factor correction better in the circuit. In this circuit, other than the burn resistors, more resistors are also used to protect the circuit from the overcurrent. These are those resistors that are used as shunt resistors. All these resistors are attached to the negative point. These resistors are used with the negative pins. Over here, when a negative needs to pass through, the single resistor is used. These five resistors are attached to the IPM pins. These resistors are fine. The overcurrent may not have passed through these resistors. I think the overcurrent might have passed through these resistors only, and these resistors have blown up. I will fix this circuit board, and we will see what further problem we find in it. Let me tell you also that this circuit board has come from another workshop where it was tried to repair. But I don't get why they couldn't repair it. Over here, a double diode is mounted. The diode number is 105. It has also been bursted. 12 volts pass through it. It has also been blown up. I will see what is the reason why this double diode got bad. First of all, I will remove these resistors from the circuit board. I have removed all the burned resistors and the double diode from the circuit board. I have physically tested the circuit board and the rest of the components. I didn't see anything further damaged physically. The rest of the components in this circuit board are fine. Only someone has worked on it, and I can see those soldering pads that have been soldered. It is not a big deal. I will test the rectification circuit. Two rectifiers are used in this circuit board. The problem has occurred between the PFC and the rectification circuit. I will check both its filtering and the PFC circuit to know whether it has any further problems or not. If I install these resistors and the diode and if it will again blow up, it could damage something else in the circuit board. I will check these bridge rectifiers. This cut is made here, which indicates that this is the positive side. The other side is the negative side. I will place the positive probe on the positive pin and the negative probe on the negative pin. I will put the multimeter on diode mode. It will show a voltage drop here. There is no voltage drop here, which means it is fine. Nothing is shown on any pins. I will now change the side of the probes. The negative probe is on the positive pin, and the positive probe is on the negative pin. The voltage drop on this pin is 0.474 volts, which is fine. Fine on the next pin as well. It is also fine on the last pin as well. If zero voltage drop is shown here, it means that pins are short-circuited. I will now check the second bridge rectifier using the same method. The second rectifier is also okay. I will now check the line filter. I will put the multimeter on resistance mode. The line filter is showing 0.4 ohms on these pins. The next two pins are also showing the same value. These readings for the line filter are okay. I will now check the reading on the opposite pins of the line filter. It should not show us any kind of reading on the multimeter. The multimeter shows 0.5 megohms. This means that the circuit board has some short circuit. I will now check its capacitors, which are really easy to test. I will put the multimeter on continuity mode. The multimeter is showing a beep when I short the probes. The multimeter passes DC voltages. The capacitors block the DC voltages. It passes the AC voltages. No beep is heard from this capacitor. I will change the sides of the probes to check the capacitor. After changing the polarity of the probes, the beep sound was heard. And then the capacitor blocked it. This means all three capacitors are fine and blocking the DC voltages because they are attached in parallel. The multimeter made a long beep because the DC voltages pass through all three capacitors. The next component I will test is the IGBT. I have put the multimeter on diode mode to test the IGBT. We should get some voltage drop on these pins. No reading is shown on this polarity of the probes. After changing the sides of the probes, the voltage drop started to show on these two pins. Now, I will test the next pin. There is no reading on these next pins. The IGBT is also okay, it has no problem with it. The IGBT could have been faulty if the multimeter had shown zero voltage drop. The next component that I will check is the IPM of the circuit board. I have placed the negative probe of the multimeter on the negative pins of the IPM. The positive probe on the first positive pin. No voltage drop should be shown by connecting the probes on this polarity. I have changed the sides of the probes. I have placed the positive probe on the negative pins and the negative probe on the positive pin. It is now showing the voltage drop on the multimeter. The value of the voltage drop is also fine. The IPM also has no issue with the circuit board. If I see the condition of the rectifier physically, someone had already worked on this circuit board. I have tested this rectifier with the multimeter, but the pins of the rectifier are turned black. I will take this rectifier out of the circuit board. Because the rectifier is normally not in this condition, the physical condition of the rectifier pins should be like the second rectifier. It should not be as this rectifier. I have removed the rectifier from the circuit board. Let me show you the condition of the rectifier by zooming the camera on it. This is the condition of this rectifier, and it has been badly burned. But on testing it with the multimeter, it shows itself okay. I have soldered a new rectifier in the circuit board. With it, I have neatly mounted all the resistors on the circuit board. I have replaced the double diode that was burned in this circuit. The number of the diode is D105. Let me tell you more about the problem this circuit board is having. I have not passed electricity through it to check it. I can't pass electricity through it until and unless I don't test it completely and confirm it is okay. The diode number 55 is mounted here. I have checked the rest of these diodes with it, which is for the SMPS circuit. Let me tell you what is the problem here. I have removed a diode from the back side of the circuit board. It seems to be short-circuited, and I will explain how it is a short circuit. The diode number is 60. I have removed these diode numbers 55 and 60 from the circuit board. I have tested them, and both are fine. When I tested the diode on the circuit board, it showed short. But after removing it from the circuit board, it started to show fine. I will check the pads of the diode where it was soldered. It should not show any reading. The diode pad still shows zero voltage drop. After changing the polarity of the probes, it still shows zero voltage drop, which means that the circuit board is also having a problem somewhere else. I will now check what reading the pads of diode number 60 shows us. It is also showing zero voltage drop. Let me tell you where the problem is in this circuit that's causing this short. I will put the multimeter on continuity mode. I will zoom the camera in again. The capacitor number 64 is mounted in this circuit. This capacitor is continuously beeping. I will change the side of the multimeter's probes and then check it. The capacitor 64 is shorted. Due to this, the pads of the diodes 55 and 60 show short circuit. I will now replace this capacitor, and after doing it, let's see whether the SMPS of the circuit board turns on. The situation over here has changed now. I have removed the capacitor from here. The capacitor number is 64. Still, the short circuit is present here. Let me tell you what kind of short circuit is present in this circuit board now. The complete circuit is shorted. Let me explain to you how. This diode is attached to the pins of IPM. Pin number 1 is the VCC. The 2 number pin is ground in the IPM. 15 volts pass through it. The 15 volts also passes through this capacitor. This diode is installed here for its protection. A short circuit is present over here, too. I am taking note that wherever there is VCC and ground, over there, I am seeing a short circuit. If I see the components without the VCC and ground, I didn't find any short circuits on those components. You might be thinking, what component in this circuit board is bad that it is short-circuited in this way? Is it the microcontroller? Or any other component? Let me tell you what is bad in this circuit board. I have seen it through the microscope, and after observing it, I have found the fault in it. We were fixing the overcurrent problem on this circuit board. Due to this, the resistors were blown up. I forgot to test the overcurrent circuit, which is very important. Let me show you where the overcurrent circuit is located here. Resistors are mounted here. These resistors are 150, 151, 148, and 147. The relation of these two resistors is directly used to detect the voltage and the current. This IC is mounted here with these resistors, and the IC number is 104. This IC is short-circuited. When I saw it under the microscope, I clearly saw a hole inside it. I have cleaned the IC a little. It is visible to some extent now. Otherwise, it was not visible. I have removed the IC from the circuit board. I showed you the problem in this IC. This complete circuit over here with these resistors and the components around this IC is for detecting the AC voltages and current. There is another circuit present here, which is used to detect the DC peak current and voltages. Both these ICs are mounted here to detect it. As the overcurrent has arrived from here through the circuit, it has made both the AC and the DC voltage and current detection circuits burn. These ICs were also not visible that they are faulty. After cleaning them, it is clearly visible that these chips also have holes in them. I will replace both of these ICs with new ones. All the capacitors and the resistor around it. It is important to check them too. Because any of the resistors or the capacitor is bad, then it will be really important to replace them. Otherwise, this circuit board will not be fixed. That is why I will check this complete circuit. If your circuit is also having a problem, do check the smaller components to verify everything is fine in the circuit board. These are the three ICs that are bad, and I have removed them from the circuit board. All of them have holes and are short-circuited. After removing these ICs, when I check the circuit board now, all the short circuits that the capacitors and the rest of the components were showing have vanished. I have only removed those three ICs that I showed you. I didn't remove any other component from the circuit. Other than this, I removed this capacitor and the diode from the circuit. Rest, I didn't remove anything from the circuit. I will check if any resistor is still bad in the circuit. Before removing the ICs, this capacitor was showing a beep on the multimeter. But now, this same capacitor is not showing any beep on the multimeter. I will check the continuity of the capacitor number 64 pins. No short circuit is present in this circuit now. This means that this circuit board has chances that it might get fixed. The overcurrent problem will be fixed after soldering new ICs in the circuit board. Now, the overcurrent problem in this circuit has been fixed. It's time to test the circuit board. Before testing the circuit, let me tell you one thing. One of the viewers contacted me on WhatsApp and told me that he took the circuit board to repair. The repair guy took some money from me, and they reset the circuit board. I told him that there is no such thing to reset in the mini split air conditioner circuit board, because mainly the components in the circuit board go bad, which makes it faulty and not work. I haven't seen the reset function in any circuit board of a mini split air conditioner. I have replaced this IC in this circuit board. And no one can say that this IC has been replaced here on the circuit board because I did it neatly. I removed the diode from here, and I have soldered it back neatly in the circuit board. I will now test it, and let's see what it does. I have attached the multimeter probes with the pins of the IPM. I will power the circuit board. The circuit board has been switched on. The relay has turned on. If I see the voltages on the IPM, they also seem to be okay. I will change the red probe and place it on the next pin of the IPM. 11 volts are shown here on this pin, which is fine. This circuit board has been fixed. I will test this circuit board that I repaired on its unit and see whether it functions properly or not. I have power on the indoor unit. The operation light in the indoor unit is lighted up. The blower motor has also started to work. I will wait for a couple of minutes. Then, the fan blower and the compressor will start to work. The fan and the compressor of the unit have started to operate. And it operates its complete functions. This means that this circuit board has been perfectly fixed. If you are willing to support the channel, you can buy me coffee. For that, visit Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.